And there's a couple of computers in there as well, and the whole place just looks a thousand times better. Hello, Flight Sim fans. Welcome back to the Practically Geek channel. Today I'm going to be showing you an airport in the Netherlands called Ameland Airport, and this is by Sinus JC, who you may remember from a previous video. Him and Garfield made the wonderful little Middenmeer aerodrome, also in the Netherlands. So, Ameland Airport inside Microsoft Flight Simulator. I laugh because last time I did a little flight from this in my little Microlite, the Aerolite 103, I couldn't really see where anything was. So I've started off on the end of the runway now, and you can see some marks here. The grass strip here at Ameland is exactly 800 meters. You can see it just off going off into the distance there. And then you can see kind of this brownish grass taxiway here. And in fact, the main sort of apron or body of the airport is actually way over here. So the planes do, the little GA airplanes do have a little a little trip to go. Just over here is the main, as I say, the main area, the main body of the airport. It does also have a helipad, which apparently is used for search and rescue nowadays. But this is the body of the airport, as I've said three times already. This is a hangar, and this, in real life, is the control tower. But the Autogen wants you to think it's a little bungalow. So, the reason why I wanted to feature this is mainly because Sinus JC did a massive, him and Garfield did a really great job on the Middenmeer aerodrome. It's tiny, just like this one, but I really wanted to feature this one today. It's small, and we're not going to be in the default scenery for long. And with that said, I think let's go and see what Sinus JC has done with this one. Okay, so welcome back to Ameland Airport here in the Netherlands. And we are loaded into Sinus JC's scenery, and we're gonna have a look at it right now. So as you can see, he has done an amazing job of making sure that the taxiways and the runways are now visible with different colored cones. You can see an assortment of blue cones and maybe the yellow or white cones. And the whole place now looks like it's meant to be there. There's nowhere getting confused on where the runway is or where the taxiways are. And you can also see that he's added the solar farm here on the left of the runway. That looks really great. But where the big change is near the actual airport itself, or the airfield. You can see that the helipad is now there with the fuel station nearby. We now have an assortment of static aircraft as well, which it didn't before. The place didn't really look like an airfield or an airport at all, but now you can see it has static aircraft and a couple of ground vehicles. And you can also see now that there is the custom hangar and the really amazing custom control tower, which looks really, really great. I do love the use of PBR textures and materials. And there's a couple of computers in there as well, and the whole place just looks a thousand times better. The cafe area here for visitors or pilots to get a snack. You can see actually the really, really great texture on the floor here with like the dampness and the weathering on it. And even down to these chairs with the metal sort of structures on them, it's really, really great. And if you did see the Middenmeer aerodrome, you'll know that it, you know, these guys, Sinus JC and when he works with Garfield as well, it's really, really great. Down to this wood fence here, the texture is really great. This little red and white barrier, like a clip-on barrier, the chains going across look, you know, great. And you know, they're small objects, so you know, you can get really close in and see each individual chain. Looks really great. And the, as I say, the wood as well. Also these signs look spot on as well. Propeller stay clear. Yeah, I'd imagine, yeah, he'd be dead, wouldn't he? But you know, you've got gate one there, and the hangar looks really great as well. It's like aircraft in there as well, just for added detail. Skydiving Amaland post banner there as well, and you can see that they're having a really great time. And as I say, this is a small one, guys, but you know, I thought I'd once I saw, you know, this has been in my folder for a while, actually. It's been in my to-do folder for a while, and after seeing the Middenmere one, I thought, well, I'm gonna have to revisit his other file, which is this one, and take a look. And it doesn't disappoint. It's, you know, it may be small, but the fact that this place just didn't resemble any kind of airfield or airport beforehand, and now it looks spot on. It's just amazing work. So let's rewind those clocks to 1 a.m. and have a look at the night lighting. So I must admit, obviously the airport isn't exactly overrun with buildings, but the night lighting is actually incredible. I know you might not be able to see much. You'll be able to see the lights in the buildings. Even these sort of faked windows here have got lights. And do you know what? The control tower computers in there are really great. They look spot on. So do the hangar area here. And you can see those chairs are sparkling. If you can see that, you can see like the reflections in the metal. And in terms of the rest of the airfield, there's no other night lighting. You can see the distance lighting and the surrounding lights from other buildings in the background, but that's all this airport has in terms of night lighting. But for the small amount it has, it looks really, really great. So that was a quick look at Ameland Airport by Cyanus JC. You can get this scenery over at flightsim.to absolutely free. It is a freeware. All you do is unzip the file and pop the folder within your community folder. If you do have trouble with your community folder installing, please take a look at my video in the top right popping up now, and you can it'll show you how to install, but also how to find your community folder, which is sometimes the part I know that a lot of people I speak to say that they have trouble doing it, and they can't actually find the community folder. And this method shows you how to install, but it also shows you how to find your community folder. As always, if you've liked the video, please give it a big thumbs up. And also, please subscribe to the Practically Geek channel. I do videos like this every week, or near enough every day. I do freeware reviews, payware reviews. I also do some flight tours, and I do have some more flight tours coming up very soon. Thank you for watching, and I will see you again very, very soon.